day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun, fast Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, today we're going to make another Sim Lab project. Start by hitting Create 3D Design. We are going to name this Domino Crossover. And of course, if you've built earlier lessons, you should be able to go to your creations, click on search, and if you type domino, you will find the domino that we build with. If you need to build yours from scratch, let me show you. Simply go to basic shapes, bring out the basic red cube, and the numbers we use are 6, 16, and 28. And then I set the rounded corners to 2 and press enter. Bingo, domino, make it white. And then also the way to make it your own shape is to click on your creations and hit create shape. While it's selected, name it domino and then save it for using. Of course, I've already got mine, so I don't have to do that. Friends, we're also gonna make the world a little larger. Click on the settings, delete, and let's do 800 by 800. I'm going to make a small one, but hopefully you make epic ones and share them with us. Friends, this next step, changing it to 5mm nudge, is what makes this magical. Friends, now that we've got that set, let's do the magic part. Control D, 3 clicks forward, 1 click to the left, and then we're going to rotate 22 degrees. If it turns out you need negative 22, just do that. Do not click anything else. And then just do Control D again and again so that it spins and is pointed almost straight. I am going to fix that and make it straight by just changing it like that. Now we're going to do Control D to move back. So once again, 1, 2, 3, Control D, 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 D. And this is where the crossover happens. Now, friends, we are going to do a real fun hack. Still set to 5, we can scale this down to 10. And then we can do Control D and control up to raise it up, and we're gonna simply make it something like 30. Now I'm gonna just take this domino and do control D. I'm gonna move it over with a shift nudge, rotate it 90 degrees. Once again, shift is awesome because it goes 45 degrees at a time. I'm gonna get this close, and friends, it's time to test our domino. Now my favorite way is to bring out a wedge. We're gonna go to the basic shapes. It is right here. I'm gonna back it up just a little bit. I'm gonna make it a little longer by stretching the black handle, and I'm gonna set a sphere right on top. Notice because of cruising, it lines up perfect. I'm gonna spin around and make sure those are aligned the way I want. I think it's gonna be perfect. Friends, let's give it a test by going into the motion simulator. I am gonna make it so my wedge does not move. That means I'm gonna make it static. Shortcut would be Control M. Let's hit play and see if it works. Ooh, it did not tip over. Friends, since it didn't work, we need to hit reset and let's go back and make some adjustments. And I'm gonna make this adjustment. I'm gonna click on these two pieces. Notice it says two shapes. I'm gonna do Control D, and I'm gonna nudge that forward one click. I'm gonna select these two, and I'm gonna nudge them back one click. I'm gonna click on this, I'm gonna add a couple more. Remember, it's 3 clicks forward to spread it out. Let's go back and give this one more test. Once again, motion sim. It already remembers that this one is static. We can see that right there. When we hit play, let's see if we are successful. Bingo! Crossover dominoes. We can hit pause. Don't forget, you can slide it back and rewatch it. And oh my gosh, friends, now that skill is yours and you can make this as incredible as you want. Friends, I do want to remind you while you're in here, if you like what you created, you can click on share. Pick whichever format you want. Pick the resolution, either small or large file, and you can create a video of your project that easily. When it completes, you can save it to your computer, and of course share it on all your social platforms. Friends, when you are done, you can click back on the Tinkercad dashboard. click on your design, click on the properties, make sure it's got a cool name, fill in the description. Of course, mine says tutorial coming soon because I'm making it right now. You can also find other ways to reach me on YouTube or my website. Finally, add some tags, and don't forget, friends, if you put the tag HLMT23, I check that tag almost every day to see what cool designs were shared and give them reactions. Of course, finally, change it to public so the world can see it. And of course, I always choose attribution, no derivatives, because I want you to come up here, follow the tutorial, and gain some epic skills. Friends, as I wrap up, let me remind you about my website, HLModTech.com. I've got the page dedicated to Tinkercad with a ton of awesome categories, and then right below it, the first day lessons. These are great for anybody that's just starting out in Tinkercad. Friends, I also want to highlight the super cool built-in messaging. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Friends, I do also want to highlight the link to the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, there are more than 600 members, and it's a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, of course, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL ModTech. Of course, friends, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL ModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.